Ah, the momos. Soft and delectable when steamed. Crispy and juicy when fried. These tiny dollops of savory bliss are found all over the country and abroad. With a variety of fillings and different sauces to accompany them, the momo has captured Indian hearts and Indian streets. We uncover the mystery behind the history of the momos with Shruti, our favorite food writer. Who made the momo?
I think the question is not who made the momos, but who ate the momos. The Turks say they made the momos. The Chinese say they made the momos. And we haven't even spoken to the Italians yet.
Okay, so this is gonna get complicated.
They say that the dumplings probably traveled all over Central Asia, Europe, and you know, all the way to the east, up to Korea, with the nomadic Turkic people, and later with the Mongols, which means Genghis Khan and his cohorts.
Now, what do the Chinese have to do with all of this?
So the Chinese, of course, we know, you know, they've made an art of making dumplings. 1700 years ago, there were momos in China. They found fossils of half-moon-shaped or crescent-shaped momos in a place called Turfan. And of course, when we talk of food, the Romans can't be far behind. So there's a collection of recipes called Officius in which there is a dumpling recipe. Guess what it's got in it? Roasted pheasant. I think that's really interesting.
Well, that sums it up quite well. But how did momos come to India?
Everybody's guess is that those who traveled from Tibet and settled in India started selling momos. The other route that perhaps some say that the momos could have come to India from was the route of Nepal, because the Nevari traders who used to travel all the way to Tibet and back, somewhere along the way they probably also learned the art of making momos. The Nepali community that has settled in India also continued to, you know, make momos and share them with their friends and neighbors.
Well, regardless of where it exactly came from, the momos were welcomed by Indians with open arms. With small stalls mushrooming all across the country, you'd wonder, why did the momos become so popular?
I think partly, of course, it's the sauce, because we like the spice and we find it in the sauce. The other reason is it's quick, instant gratification. The time from when you spot a momo to the time when you gobble one, you know, it's optimal. It's cheap, it's quick, you can take it and walk off with your momos. You can eat it at any time of the day. So I think that's partly why momos have become wildly popular. Now the sight of a momo steamer, it's like a smoke signal to anybody. I mean, you spot it from a distance and you gravitate towards it.